Here's how to edit eyes that really sparkle in 3 simple steps, create amazing catchlights, and get professional skin contrast using gradient maps. Let's dive straight in. Now we have this lovely image of Sinead, which I took a few months back, but the eyes are a little flat with no real sparkle or twinkle in them. So I'm going to begin by using the pen tool to select the whites of the eyes, or the sclera, which is their medical term. And if you don't know how to use the pen tool correctly, you can instead use either the lasso tool or the quick selection tool. But for this, I'll just stick with the pen tool, as the curved edges are more accurate for the shape of the eyes. Don't forget to add to selection, or it will cancel out the previous selection. And repeat the process for the other eye. Now we have a good selection, we're going to save that selection because we're going to use this again in just a moment. Let's call this eye sclera. And step one is to create a vibrance adjustment mask and reduce down the saturation by about 50%. And if we zoom in a bit, you'll see the reds and blues in the eyes have gone. And this is going to be important for the next step, which is to create a curves adjustment layer. And drag the curve up by 1 square segment, and then invert the mask using Control or Command I. Then let's get the brush tool and hardness down to 0% for that feathered edge. Now let's load up that previously saved selection from earlier, and what I'm going to do is hide that selection using Command H. The selection is still active, but it's now hidden so we can see the effect properly. Now if we make the brush roughly the same size as the iris of the eye, all I'm going to do is click a few times. About 4 or 5 times is fine. Now a quick before and after shows that the feathered edge of the brush has kept the outer edge of the eye darker than the middle, because eyes of course are round, not to point out the obvious. Bring back the selection with Command H, and then we can deselect with Command D. It's a really nice crisp edge to Sinead's eyes now. The next step is my favourite, the catchlights, which are basically the eye's reflections. So creating a new layer, let's go with a hard edge brush, and the brush colour should be just off-white. So let's go with a hexadecimal value of all of the Ds. Now placement of these catchlights are dependent on the direction of the light source, and you can normally tell this by the shadow that the nose casts across the cheek. Zooming in, you can actually see a very faint catchlight from the shoot, and the reason you can barely see it is because I was using a gridded softbox to shoot this image, which will naturally reduce the catchlights quite a bit. So I'll be creating my own. Going with a brush the same size as the pupils, let's place one in the upper left corner, just over the eyelid. Now we need to create a mask on this layer. Let's bring the brush hardness back to 0%. Oh, and making sure that the foreground color is black, because black conceals when we're working with masks. Then simply paint away the top portion along the eyelashes. And to make these look more realistic, we should have eyelash reflections. So I'm just going to paint away these with a very small brush. And that is looking pretty decent. Maybe just reduce the opacity down by 25%. Now we can simply duplicate this catchlight layer, complete with mask, and then move it over to the other eye. And because we're now on the darker side of the face, I'll reduce the opacity by, let's say, another 10%. So let's create a new layer for the final stage of the process, which is to brighten up the iris of the eye and give it some real wow factor. The brush color needs to return back to white for the best results. And the brush size can be a little bigger than the pupil. Then just paint below the pupil. And you don't have to worry about painting over the pupil, because we're going to change the blending option to overlay. The opacity can come down a touch. And on your own image, this value will be arbitrary depending on how bright the iris is to begin with. Then paint the same on the other side. And because we changed the blending option, it doesn't have any effect on those black areas. A quick before and after really shows how it defines those black pupils. Now, before we move on to this next edit, being a portrait photographer, or any photographer for that matter, it's important to be able to show potential clients the quality of your work. And that's where today's sponsor, Sahl Digital, just knocks it out of the park. Sahl Digital offers a variety of products that get your photos off the hard drive and into hard print. I've previously ordered some of their wall art pieces, metal and acrylic prints, and photo squares, and have been really impressed with the speed and quality they deliver. Their dedicated editing software allows you to select and create your product with ease. I wanted to create a portfolio book to display in my studio and to show potential clients examples of my work. For that reason, I went for Sahl's professional line XT photo book. Oh, look, there she is. Available in a variety of sizes. I went for 40 by 30. You can choose the cover type, cover material, photo paper, and there's even an option to add a custom gift box. The Clever Design Assistant offers you three options, from fully designing the book yourself to having it automatically generated for you. I opted for the middle choice, making use of their design templates but still allowing flexibility. The number of pages, again, is at your discretion, and you can easily add to or subtract from this number in the edit. You then have the freedom to add as many pictures to each page as you'd like, using the various templates available. Once selected, your pics can be edited easily, creating the optimum look for your photo book. Delivery was super quick. This item landed on my doorstep within 4 days of ordering, and as ever, the quality is absolutely gorgeous. This leatherette finish, thick pages, and print quality is first rate. I'm over the moon. Anyway, check the links in the description below for a 50% off all photo albums promotion, and go see for yourself why Sahl Digital has my vote when it comes to hard copy printing products. Right, here's this other edit, which uses a catchlight replacement technique and a skin gradient adjustment for studio lighting portraits. Now you'll notice that I have two pretty decent catchlights to begin with, but I'm going to remove them with the remove tool. Just carefully trace around them, and Photoshop does a stellar job and gives us a clean canvas to work on. You'll notice I've taken the liberty of performing those first couple of steps to brighten the sclera already, so I don't have to repeat myself. Next, create a new layer, and again with the pen tool, I'm going to create a reflection of a rectangular softbox, which in reality would appear curved like a quarter moon or a big fat banana. Then I'll get me a white brush with a nice soft edge. The size can be roughly the diameter of the catchlight selection. And on the very edge, just simply click 4 or 5 times to create this linear gradient across the catchlight. Opacity should probably reduce down by about 25%. Then we can duplicate the layer and place it over the other eye. There, looks pretty good. Now you can add another layer for the iris flare using that soft edge brush and just painting the bottom right corner. And then change the blending to overlay, with an opacity of maybe 50% on this image, which you'll remember is less than the first edited image because these eyes, they have more light on them to begin with. Now here's the trick to this studio retouch, using a gradient map adjustment. I'll be using a black and white grade for this, and we're going to add a couple of control points. One just here, and the other the same distance to the right. And make sure those new points are black and white, and it just gives a bit more punchy contrast. Okay that, and then change the blending option to overlay once again. Then you can choose the strength of the contrast enhancement, for this image around 25%. Right, here's a before and after with and without that gradient map adjustment. And to me, this is just a brilliant way to add professional contrast to a studio portrait and make those eyes just pop right off the screen. The final edit looks like this. And if you're interested in portrait photography or portrait retouching, I have a headshot photography course available, which I'll pop links to in the description. The course covers everything to do with camera gear, camera settings, lighting setup, model posing, the business side of things, and of course, the retouching process. The course has about 50 videos and 5 hours of training on the course, so it's very comprehensive. I also have a preset pack available on my website, so give that a check out as well. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more photography content. Hit that like button if you would please, and I'll see you on the flip side.